Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Today I decided to talk about this specific topic. I don't know if you guys know what is this, but this is a fuel model. This fuel model is going to be for DD13s, DD15s and DD16s trucks from 2013 and up, but all the older trucks can use this type of fuel model because the older three-stage fuel model was discontinued completely. So this is the only one left. Even the 2020 trucks still use the same type of fuel model. Today what I'm gonna do is to explain you, to show you where are all the components of this fuel model. And for that, we're gonna take it apart. And that will be the point of this video, so you understand how this fuel system works. Because in order to repair something, you have to understand how something works. So let's start with the video. So the fuel module is composed by two different areas. On this filter size, we have two different areas, right? We have this is the low size. This is the size that comes from the actual tanks or the fuel water separator. And we have the pressure size over here. This over here is going to be the pressure side. So the pressure side is the one that is gonna come after the fuel pump. So you're gonna have suction on this area and you're gonna have pressure on this area. So on the suction area, you're gonna have the filter. You're gonna have a screen filter. This filter is meant just to trap major kind of debris, metal type of debris that are coming from the tank. That's all the point of this filter. It cannot retain a small microscopic debris because you can see how open this screen is. So as soon as you open this, there is one check valve. As soon as you open this one, there is one check valve. And it is right here. You can see it right there. That little valve over there, that little valve, that is a check valve. So that is there, that is a check valve. And to actually see if that is working, all you have to make sure then every time you open this one, when you open to replace the fuel, I mean the fuel filters, when you open it like this, all you have to make sure then in here, fuel stays. Fuel gotta stay over here. If fuel drains completely right away, as soon as you remove this filter, that means that check valve is not good. So to remove it, all you have to do is to pull it like this. It's kind of hard because it's trapped in there. So this check valve is a plastic valve. It is not metal. It is just a plastic valve. Then it is no different than any other type of check valve that you can find in other different type of fuel systems. It can wear over the time because it's plastic. But the thing is, like, I'm not sure if you can buy it separately, if you can buy just the little valve just to place the new one in case it is completely bad, because if the fuel is draining from this side, this is what you have to replace. But anyway, this is one check valve that you have to replace. So I'm gonna put it right there and we're gonna continue with the video over here. So next to the check valve, we have this, I mean to the fuel filter, we have this. This is just a prime pump. It is just a prime pump. This prime pump is meant to open and pump fuel through here. It sucks the fuel from here and send it to the area over here. So it goes to the pump and then goes to the filter over here. So that's the whole point of this prime and pump. It's pretty simple. I mean, this has nothing to do if your engine doesn't start right away. It will have problem if your engine doesn't start right away, when probably the cranks and doesn't start, probably what the problem could be the O-ring that is leaking or something, or the fuel inside, the fuel pump in here is bad. So it doesn't have problems like that, but it could happen. Anyway, so we put that on the side and then we go to the bigger filter. The bigger filter, we have Nothing special. I'm pretty sure you already see how this one looks in real life, because if you already did an oil change or replaced your fuel filters, it's pretty much the same for all of them, for all DD15s or DD13s. It doesn't matter what year they are. So after that, we have here, inside here, this part over here, this part is just the bracket, the plastic bracket where the fuel filter goes. Nothing else. It is just a direction bracket. It has nothing like special about it. So which means then this one won't be like, doesn't have a check valve, doesn't have nothing. It is just a straight bracket, a plastic bracket, just to keep this one on position. That's all. So you can easily remove it and put it back, and we know where it is, then this one is going to have a check valve, and you will know how it goes or something like that. So we have in this area, this is the housing area now. So in this area we have this sensor. This sensor is going to be the low pressure sensor. This is the one that is going to measure the pressure coming from the fuel pump to the housing. It is just a pressure sensor. It should read around like 80 to 110 PSI, something like that. This is the pressure of the housing in this area. So when the fuel travels, it travels to the fuel pump and then goes back. Here is some pressure, and then from here goes to the high pressure fuel pump and then goes back to the engine, I mean to the injectors. So we have these things over here. Many of you think that these are check valves. These are not check valves, these are just fittings. See, they have nothing. These are the return and the inlet of the fuel. So the inlet is going to be bigger, the return is going to be smaller on size. That's all. Here is where the fuel goes through over here. See, it goes all the way in, all the way it goes in that direction. And the other one is from the where the fuel is coming from. Now, on the bottom area over here, we have the fuel water separator area. So this part over here is going to be fuel water separator, and this is going to be the drain valve. Whenever you have fuel in the system, you open this drain valve like this to the left, and it's going to drain fuel from this hose over here, and it's going to go away from the system. So to open this drain valve, it's pretty easy. You have to remove this one from here, see, like this, completely. Remove this one completely from here and you get it off. It's pretty easy. You have two seals and that's all it has. Nothing special. So the fuel water separator area is going to be under this filter right here. So this filter is going to be on top, because this filter is going to have fuel water separator capability. So you're going to have water in case you have water and fuel in this area. And the reason is because, you know, fuel can be contaminated with water, and also you need to know when there is fuel and water, and that's the reason why you have a sensor here. See, this is a sensor, a fuel water separator sensor, and it has these two pins over here. These two pins are meant to connect when there is water in the system. So this is the way it looks, nothing special, and you can see how it looks from here. You can see it goes directly to the other side over here, so it is nothing special about it. It is just one way. Now, on this side, this is the other side of the fuel filter housing. This is a complete bracket and goes all together with bolts. You can see that many bolts over here. On this side, we're gonna have a check valve. This over here, this is a check valve. This is a check valve. Then works with a low pressure size. In case there is overflow of the fuel pressure over here, you're just gonna let it go in the other direction, so that way it doesn't damage other components. Or it will retain fuel, so that way the fuel pump doesn't get completely dry every time it starts. So if you're having problems on your engine, then doesn't start right away, when you start it in the morning and the engine doesn't start right away, it cranks and it takes a while. All you have to use the starting fluid to start it. Pretty much you have to use you have to replace these two valves, this one right here and this one right here. These are the ones that you have to replace, and that could be your solution to the problem. If this one doesn't fix the problem, that means then the fuel housing could be the whole problem. The fuel filter housing, it has many things inside than you are about to see. We have another check valve over here. This check valve, it is just for the return of the injectors, because we have the lines over here. These lines are the for the return of the injectors and everything. And this check valve is just meant to be if there's overflow or to retain a specific pressure in the system. It doesn't have anything to do with the high cranking time when you are in the morning, then the engine doesn't want to start and it just cranks. This one has nothing to do with that. So then we have this area over here, so we have to remove all the bolts right here. So this is a whole unit. It is different pieces that compose the fuel system, so we're gonna talk about this one later. But we can see over here, this is how the fuel travels. You can see this is a seal, and the fuel travels in different directions depending from where and from what is going to do over here. So you can see fuel comes from one direction, another direction, another direction. For example, you can see here, this is the entrance of the fuel that comes from the fuel tanks. So if we look closely over here, you can see the light over there, see? That is where the fuel is coming from. So right from here, this is the entrance of the fuel water separator, where the fuel is coming from the tanks. And if I light the light from the other side, you can see the light too, see? So that's how you're gonna see. So we have another one here, we can say. So we have the return, right? The return goes right here. So see, the return is right there. See, I'm lighting the light on the return. So it comes right here. And it's all in the same size, but everything separate just because of this seal. So the same way goes to this little light over here. See, you can see the light on that little orifice right there. See the little light over there? See, that's where I'm moving, and that one is coming from the inside. And so everything else, right? So that's how everything is separate in circuits, in different circuits, but just because of these seals. So probably if you're having problems with the fuel water separator, I mean with the fuel system, but you have to, you don't know what's the problem, you have to replace all that. But it's not only that, I mean the seal and everything is one thing, but you have these things over here. These all are check valves. See, this one check valve, see? It's one check valve over here. We have another check valve over here. This is another check valve. See? And it goes on the other side. We have another check valve over here. See? And I think there is no more. There is only two. The only ones over here. This is kind of the way the fuel system works, and this is how it looks when it's completely open. And then we have the coolant line. For the newer ones, you won't have this coolant line because the newer trucks don't have any more a cooler in this area. They have a straight line that goes from 2017-19. So this one is completely off, including this one. This one, the pipe is right here, but the pipe doesn't do anything because there is no cooler over here, see? The cooler is going to be right here. And this area over here, see, is completely sealed. There is no water going in there. So that means that there is no cooler, and this one is completely off. So there is no reason for this to be here, but the newer ones are completely different because they don't have this one anymore. That's not needed in the newer ones. This one over here, if you wonder what this is to use the tool. If you have the tool to measure the pressure of the fuel system or to refill the fuel system, you use this plug, you connect the adapter here, and then you fill it or you measure the pressure of the low side pressure system over here. This whole thing is connected to here. This thing is connected to this housing over here because this is where the pressure is going to be, the low pressure side. So pretty much this is all. It looks kind of shorter in a way because I think it's not so hard to understand how this one works. If for any reason if you have the old three-stage fuel filter housing, that one is going to be completely different. That one you cannot take it apart the same way as this one, but on that filter you're gonna have, let me see, two major check valves. There will be one check valve on the filter, the screen filter too. The small filter is gonna be a check valve, then goes inside. So when you remove the filter, there's gonna be a plastic valve under. So that is a check valve. You can replace it to fix problems or hard cranking or never start, or you have to do starting fluid to start the engine. And then you have the return check valve. Then it's going to be like this one, but it's gonna be an Allen wrench over here, then you have to remove it. It's going to be in this area over here. Also, you have another check valve that is going to be for the regent. Then it's going to be for the fuel compensation. It's going to be a return check valve that comes from the injectors. It's gonna be a check valve like this, and that is gonna be only for regent purposes, nothing to do with hard cranking. But I think I explained myself pretty well, but if I didn't, just use the comment section below. There you can leave any of the questions, then probably I didn't answer, or probably recommendations or anything else then this video didn't cover, you can add it too, because it's very important that you share your opinions there, because everybody can learn something different if you do share them. I think this is all up today. Just remember, for the two-step filter we have two major check valves, and it's going to be this and this. I already showed you the locations, so it is pretty easy now for you. Also, if you have a fuel water separator that goes mounted close to the radiator, you're gonna have another check valve that looks like this one, and you have to replace it too. That probably can be the cause of many other problems then going to be related to the fuel system. Anyway, I guess I don't have anything else to show you for the moment. And probably later I'm gonna do a different video having or probably doing some kind of repairs on a fuel water separator, or fuel water system, fuel filter system, or trying to fix a problem then is hard cranking or something, and show you what was the solution, so that way you can understand how this one works better. You already understand how this one is composed and how the fuel direction it is. It is not just a piece of metal, it is something that is being made to work in a specific form, and that's the reason you have to understand it if you need to repair it. So if you have any question about the video, make sure to comment, or you can message me on Instagram. Go to Instagram, Francisco Maya YouTube, and you can ask me anything there. Just be patient if I don't reply right away. If you like the video, make sure to like it, make sure to share it with anybody else that wants to learn more about this. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and support my channel too, that is very important. Check the description below, I have details how to support my channel, so that way I can continue making content like this for all of you that want to learn, and probably next video probably can be helpful for you too. So it's very important for you to support my channel, that way I can do my time and I can have different content coming on for all of you. So make sure to stay tuned for the next video coming soon, and thank you for watching.